Thank you, Chair. The state of this member's item is fairly self-explanatory. Basically, it's an issue that has been raised at the Housing Committee. Somewhat bizarrely, there seems to be some confusion as to which committee deals with the headline the achievement or non-achievement of housing targets in the borough. So I put this down as a member's item at Policing Resources Committee, because clearly this being one of the key committees, surely this committee can discuss affordable housing targets and the non-achievement of those affordable housing targets. One of the things that this report does highlight is the fact that our record is not good when compared with other boroughs. It's not good in the delivery, the supply of new housing, and it's not good in the percentage of that new housing which is affordable. Now, I think, you know, this is clearly for residents a very critical issue. It's clearly an issue for us as councillors to be concerned about. And it's clearly a matter of great public concern. We achieved for the period of 2014-15 only 55% of our London plan target. So in other words, what the Mayor of London thinks we should have been achieving in terms of new build. We also only achieved over the last 2012-15 period, as the IGC that sets out 28% affordable, which is way, way below what we should be achieving, which in our own policies say it should be 40%. And this situation is only going to get worse because it's going to get worse in the sense that actually a percentage of that affordable, given the passing of the housing bill, actually some of that percentage of affordable will now be taken up to start homes. So actually underachieving on it is actually going to be delivering an even smaller amount of affordable that is actually genuinely affordable. I mean, one of the comments, and it's interesting, I was reading the Camden New Journal the other day, and there was an article about the Bishop of London. I'm not sure he's a particularly well-known member of the sort of hard left tendency, the current Lord Bishop of London. But he was visiting a scheme in Barnet where he was told about the developers delivering starter homes, and he said what sort of value are these starter homes being sold at? £450,000. And the Bishop of London clearly thought that was outrageous. So, there is a real issue because we're underachieving. In the current regime, we're underachieving. The new regime is going to make it even harder to deliver affordable housing. So, because actually people are going to be using it to deliver £450,000 worth of homes, and calling it affordable, and that's what the government seems to think is acceptable in London. I think it's really critical that we get rid of, we up our game on this, because if 28% is affordable under the current regime, if you're top slicing a chunk of that for starter homes, it's going to make it even lower. And all of this report asks is that the committee consider these figures and we get a report back reviewing how the council's policy that 40% of new development is affordable is being implemented and delivered, and whether the council needs to do something different to enforce the policy and meet the targets. Now, we've recently had a mayoral election, and that mayoral election was called a referendum on housing, and I think your party lost that referendum. And I think it's important as a council, that London Plan is a London-wide document. And we have obligations under the London Plan, the existing London Plan, and so what I'm asking for is a report come back Because I do think this is one of the most critical issues facing this council, and I think we need to be looking at those figures and asking for explanations as to why we're not.
Yes, please, and I admire your use of statistics here. I think there are other ways of interpreting these statistics that show Barnet in a much better way. Yes, David, would you like to comment on those?
No, I'd only say in the first instance, Barnet residents voted overwhelmingly for a Conservative candidate in all the elections that have just gone. So whilst London Mayor voted for a Labour Mayor, residents of Barnet are certainly bluer than ever. And in terms of the numbers here, I think I find it rather strange that on the one hand we are criticised by Labour for building lots and lots of houses, and yet now the indication from Council of Houston seems to be we should be building even more. So I think the Labour side need to get their message straight. I think we're doing a very good job. I think it's very interesting that the numbers are only 14, 15 that have been chosen to be quoted in this paper. I'd be very interested in seeing how those numbers look across all boroughs over a 5 or 6 year period. And I think it's working in Barnet, and I don't see any reason to change, but of course, it's a decision for the committee to make.
Oh,
yeah,
it's wonderful. It's wonderful.
I find that a remarkable answer. We know that our residents perceive housing to be their top concern. We also know that that we have a set of targets. We have agreed as local authority. We are not. Is Councillor Davey for 1 second suggesting that we are meeting the 40% target? If we're not, then there is something that we should be. That should be a matter of concern, and I think it's perfectly reasonable because I do think it's such a critical issue. And given the background of the housing bill as well, and how many actions come, that we should be looking at these figures, and this is apparently the committee that should be looking at them. I think this is a matter of the utmost concern and the utmost priority, and I do think those figures are not. We are not saying that. I'm slightly confused about what Councillor Davey is saying, because actually we're saying you're not delivering on the amount of housing, new housing of all tenures, that you said you would deliver under the London Plan. And bear in mind that London Plan was put together by the previous mayor, not the current mayor. And we're also, those targets were agreed with the previous mayor. And also, that we're not happy that the percentage of affordable of that 50% that 55% is being delivered is so low. So we're not happy with the percentage of affordable of that which is being built, and we're not happy also with the fact that we're only supplying the housing in the first place.
Councillor Thomas.
Thank you, Chairman. I appreciate there was a comment made here as to which committee deals with housing. Of course, Councillor Davies' committee deals with housing, but the amount of regeneration going on at the moment, it's right, my committee as well, has a housing aspect, and that will continue for some time, I suspect. On the regeneration estates, and these figures that have been quoted here are quite selective for the last 3 years. If you look at the last 2010-2011 to now, it's 39% affordable housing has been delivered by Barnet. If you look at the number of houses being built in terms of the thousands, not a percentage of a target set by an external body, it's in the thousands. We are outperforming in terms of number, and it's often said that these other boroughs are smaller. Actually, they're not delivering the homes to their potential as well. Back in 2010, we had set a 15-year housing strategy to deliver 20,000 new homes. That is the most important target, as far as I'm concerned, as far as this council is concerned, because it's deliverable and it's within our control, and we can achieve that. So that's 20,000 new homes. You look at Camden, was quoted a minute ago. If you look at Camden, they promised 6,000 new homes in 2014, half of which would be affordable, and they have built a couple of hundred affordable homes. They are performing so badly that 90% of their approvals from now until 2018 would have to be affordable from the hit day target. The community investment programme is in trouble, and they now accept that they need private partnerships with their community investment programme, which is in trouble as well. So certainly we'll take no lectures from other councils, certainly neighbouring councils, on delivering housing. And as I said, they have a 4 or 5 year strategy, which I've not seen them come up with a decent replacement for that, and it expires this year. So they're in a bit of a mess.
How many people in West End are
Chairman. So if you look at the bigger picture, if you look at what we've got planned and what we're delivering, we're doing a good job on housing. And when this is discussed, I appreciate Councillor Hoosman isn't on the ART committee, but there is an annual report that comes to the committee that discusses this in detail. Where his colleagues can raise that as well.
That
will be discussed. We've had that discussion on the ART committee. I'm quite happy to have it elsewhere in the council. But we are doing a good job, and this is just selective 3 year statistics. We are looking over a long period and beyond, actually.
These are not figures that I've pulled out.
These are
from the London time frame.
You'll be selecting on the time frame.
Yeah. Well, but on a wider time frame, our record is not good. And perhaps, I'm asking for a report back. I'm sure the report can address all the time frames involved. I don't have a problem with that. I just want to make sure that we are paying too due attention to our obligations deliver a decent percentage, the target percentage of world housing that we are obliged to.
The percentage
and this is asking for a report, and a report can address those matters, and a matter of time frame, and look at several time frames in the box.
Councillor Lumsdale.
Thank you, Leader. At the recent Elmbank proposal in my area, there was an awful lot of arguing between council officers, arguing for as much affordable housing as possible, and obviously the developers trying to maximise their profits, quite reasonably. After lots of discussions, both went to independent arbitration, analysis was done on all the figures, and an agreed figure for a percentage of affordable housing was agreed. Now, if that figure had not been agreed by both parties, we'd still end up with derelict land, with derelict buildings on them. So, yeah, I can see what you mean when you write percentages, but percentages mean nothing if you build nothing. As far as I'm concerned, it's a pointless report, because numerical targets cause nothing but dysfunctional behaviour.
Councillor Orbach. Just a general point. It would be nice if the Conservative group took more page out of Councillor Rosenberg's book, welcoming the Mayor of London in this election and looking forward to working with him on building more housing.
I may have been one of the first to send him an email.
That's very good. A public amendment to the Southern Beacon, we do need to address the housing crisis in the city and the fact that we need to play our part in delivering it.
Yes, and we are. Councillor Moore.
There's a lot of battling around the numbers and percentages, but the reality is we have had a period in Barnet over the last 10 or 12 years where we've had significant state generations progressing forward, where we haven't even attempted to replace affordable housing that was there in some cases. And we've had private developments like Beaufort Park, where people have come back to the committee to reduce the affordable housing level. And the reality is that you can use figures in whichever way you like, but the reality is that housing is problematic in London, and we have not been building.
And Catherine, you use an important word, reality. Does anyone complain about the number of houses built in the last 12 years? I mean, how many houses were actually built when Labour voted out?
As I perhaps have the collective memory of the council from the old council, as remember, I might be wrong, but perhaps there's some of the other councillors over concluding me, right or wrong, I don't think any were built in the period, the 8 year period of stagnation when the Labour Party should be wrong, but as far as I remember, I don't think any houses were built like that. So, Alison, what have you been telling me?
You'll be aware that the rules and the opportunities were not there for a good chunk of that.
The regeneration schemes, where there has been reconfiguration of the houses, so instead of just looking at social rent, if it's been affordable, we look at affordable to buy as well. So that's when council talks about the loss of social housing. Forget that we're trying to create more affordable housing to buy as well as to rent. But that also ignores the fact that since 2010 we've built 1,400 affordable homes to rent, so we've helped deliver that lot because there have been other organisations, housing associations. It's good that so you've had 1,400 there. We've got a plan to build up to 800 council homes as well over the next 5 to 6 years. So when you look at affordability, we are trying to bring in different models. It's not just council rented, it's also housing association. It is also council rented, it's affordable homes to buy. And that's, we are having creating mixed communities, not just having, you know, a huge estate
where
of council rented. So the 450,000 mark is the IFA, is the cap. It's not actually the highest. Sorry, the lowest demand for a start home. It's the cap. And we work with people like Pocket Homes. Again, that's come to my committee.
How
many
do you think
who are building homes, dealing in Camden between 160,000 and 250,000 pounds. They're the sort of schemes that we need to get kids started. My committee is looking at it, as well as Councillor Davies. I think that's probably the best that we can continue this debate and come up with some practical policies.
If I might suggest there's a way forward, the statistical work does come from both committees, I understand. So, which it seems senses are duplicated by bringing it here. But what may happen is that there'll be a change of policy by Mayor Khan, which would have to come to this committee, and at that stage we would need to draw it all together. I think his sense is doing the work now. He was saying he wanted a 50% target, so presumably he will reduce his housing numbers substantially in order to achieve that, and that's something we would have to consider later on. So, can you live with that, Councillor Houston?
We need to be monitoring this, and a committee needs to be monitoring this, and as a priority. And we Councillor Davies will know this, and I'm not saying this was his ruling, it was what we were told, that actually Housing Committee shouldn't be discussing these sort of things, and I think that's absolutely nonsense. Which is why I put it on the agenda here. Although I do think this ought to be a very high level a matter for the Council of Policy and Resources, not an appropriate committee, as you've just conceded today. I think that the second, I welcome Councillor Thomas's mention of delivering 800 council homes. I'm glad he's trying to match the Labour budget amendment, and if that's a policy change from this administration, I fully welcome it. Well, that's not what I was said at the budget meeting, and not what's in the figures at the moment. The other thing, obviously, is that we will have to discuss this in the light of any redrafted London plan. I do accept that. But actually, we're talking about the existing London plan and the fact that, you know, a borough like Harrogate can deliver 53% affordable, and we're on 28%. A very poor figure of the 3-year average. And as long as I've been a councillor, we've always, and that's quite a long time now, it's over a decade, we've always been at the bottom of the barrel in terms of percentage affordable.
At any rate, we're going to need a report to come back when the Mayor's housing targets are set. And at that stage, I think the statistics should be looked at by this committee. In the meantime, and otherwise the percentage should go to a half. Yeah. Is that agreeable? Can you do that?
Yeah.
Working with. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Councillor Orbach.